Hello everyone and welcome to VLAN Tech Corner. In this video, we're going to talk about the internet service providers and how do we replace the device that they provided us. For example, this is the GPON and router from ZTE to the device that is from our own. For example, we're going to replace it with the GPON XFP module. Alright, so first let's talk about the connection and the cable. So when the fiber cable usually come to your house, it will be in the SCAPC connectors or the form factors, and then it will be inserted to this port on your ISP provider's device, something just like this. All right, and different types of internet service provider had different types of OLTs or optical line terminals, and for different provider and different devices, they have a different ways of authorization. Okay, for some device, it is going to be authorized by the GPON serial number, and for some ISP, it's going to be authorized by MAC address, and for some device, it is going to be authorized by the MAC address and then the serial number as well as the SLID, and sometimes is it a PLOAM. So a lot of thing, a lot of factor. So the use case is also different from one to another. And in order to replace the device from the internet service provider in a GPON and SCAPC connector, you will need an XFP module. So this is a GPON XFP module from Hisense, and this is the model. It is LTE3415 SCA Plus. As you can see, GPON ONU with MAC. Okay, this module had an SCAPC connector, and it will be connected something like this. All right. So the cable from the internet service provider will go to this way. Okay. And this XFP module, the GPON XFP module, will be connected to one of the XFP plus or XFP port. So right here, I have the router X and we have the XFP port right here. So after that, it will be connected this way. Alright, but in the previous video, we already set up the Zimaboard with the Mellanox ConnectX-3 in a very cheap budget. So in this video, I'm going to replace my internet service provider provided ONU with this XFP GPON module and install it on the Mellanox ConnectX-3 with the Zimaboard. So let's get started. So this is the fiber cable from the internet service provider go to my apartment, and we can see that it is in yellow color. So let me go down to the production test lab, and this is my production network setting. So this is the Zimaboard, and let us install the modules and the fiber cable. So this is the fiber cable, and this is the SCAPC connector that we just talked about. This is the GPON XFP module, and let's connect the cable to the module. So it will be something like this. Alright. Alright, perfect. This looks good. Now let's connect the module to the Zimaboard. So the Ethernet cable, this one will be connected to my PC. The USB right with OpenWRT installed just now. And the power cable. Alright, the Zimaboard is up and running with OpenWRT, and we can see that the orange LED on this module is also up and running. So let's go back to the PC and proceed with the configuration. So let's go to 192.168.1.1 and let's check it out. Let's go to network interfaces, and on the device tab, you can see that Ethernet 0, Ethernet 1, and Ethernet 2 have been added to the bridge LAN, and you can see it is right here. The reason I do this is because I am currently configuring the OpenWRT router with no monitor. So just to make sure all the network adapter are attached to bridge LAN so that I can manage it via the web. Still, the E41D Ethernet 0 is our Mellanox ConnectX-3. So this one, it should be our one port, all right? And for Ethernet 1 and Ethernet 2, it is the internal network port of the Zimaboard. So I'm going to remove the Ethernet 0 from the LAN bridge because it belongs to the GPON XFP port, all right? All right, so for my Hisense LTE3415 module, it has the default IP address 192.168.1.1. So in this case, I will need to change my LAN IP address to something different. Maybe .5.1, for example, and hit save and apply. All right, maybe interrupt. Apply and keep the setting. So now let's try to disable the connection and enable it so that we can reach the router with a new LAN IP address. All right, everything is working so far. So we can go to the new IP address and perfect. Now we need to open the connection to the GPON module. And if you have been watching my video, you should know how to do it. It is very simple. Just hit the add new interface and I will put it a GPON. For the protocol, it will be static IP address. And for the device, it should be Ethernet 0 because this is where the XFP module or the XFP GPON module is connected. So let me see, for the firewall, I will put it 1. And for the IPv4 address, it should be one of the IP address that is in the same subnet with the GPON module, which is 192.168.1.1. So I will put it .1.5 and change the subnet mark to 255.255.255.0. Everything looks good. Hit save and then save and apply. And after we configure the IPv4 address for the GPON module that we have just set, we have an active RX and TX. So let's see if we can ping the modem or the GPON module at 192.168.1.1. And perfect, we have the response. So let's log into that. So depends on the vendors of the GPON, you will have different time to manage it. You can configure it the web UI, for example, this Hisense has a web UI as well as the Telnet or SSH connection. And this is a overall device status page where you have the system up and running and the IP address and something like that. And on the PON status, you can see that it is up and running. We have the TX and the RX power as well as the GPON ONU state 05. 05, which means successfully authorization, so which means everything is working as expected. All right, so there are several ways. For example, the web UI configuration where you can set up your GPON. So here is the GPON settings of the module. And right here, we can change the LOID, LOID password, POOAM, and serial number. And beside that, for the MAC address, as well as all the information like hardware ID or something, you will need to change it via SSH or Telnet, okay? The configuration and the information you need to change, it also depends on the internet service provider. For example, my case, I am using Viettel, the OLT is ZTE, and the ONU, which is the device provided to me, is also ZTE. So I will need to get the serial number, the MAC address, so that it can work. All right. So let's go to the statistics before we open the edit edge connection to the GPON module. All right, so let's open PuTTY and have a Telnet. So this is Telnet and the IP address will be 192.168.1.1. Please bear in mind that not all GPON have the same IP address, it is different. So the login will be admin and the password, the default password one will be admin. So when you purchase the GPON module, you will have the user manual, and here I have filtered out some of the basics one. For example, with the flags get GPON serial number, you can get the serial numbers of the device, which is this one. And to enter a new GPON serial number, you need to use this command, which is flag set GPON serial numbers and followed by your GPON serial number. And this one is also case sensitive, so make sure you input the correct one. After that, we have the PON vendor ID. We can use the get and the set command to do that, for example, right here. So this is the ZTEG. And usually the vendor ID will be the first four digits from the GPON serial number. All right. So here is the MAC address. And from what I know, FPT, Internet Service Provider from Vietnam, is also authorized by MAC address. And if you're using FPT, then you can change the ELAN MAC address. Okay. Before move on, I need to mention that for the set MAC address, you need to put the MAC address with those the semicolons or colons or space. All right. So it would be AABBCCDDEFF like this. The next one is the flat VLAN configuration. So if you go back to the web page, you will have, let's say on the SVN, we have the VLAN settings, and right now we are in auto VLAN, which means whatever VLAN from your internet service provider from the OLT will be sent to your GPON module. All right. So in this case, you will need to create a PPPoE with VLAN 35 if the PPPoE is running on VLAN 35, and you can set up your IPTV on a different VLAN, for example. However, with the manual VLAN, you can tag the VLAN. For example, if you enable the manual VLAN right here and you select the tagging mode is 35, then the GPON will handle all types of connection and it will only send the traffic from VLAN 35 to your device or your OpenWRT device. All right, so this is auto. Auto equal 0. And menu equal 1. All right, so after you set this one, then you can change the VLAN right here. And right here, you can also check the GPON authorization status by this command. So actually, there are a lot of things you can play around with the GPON module. For example, if we go to T8, and then we can what GPON get and you stay, you will see the operation state, which is 05. And if you type, I believe if you type the question mark, you will see a lot of command that you can do. So, and the same, all right. So the same right here, we also have a lot of command, okay. So this instruction is for the Hisense LTE3415 module. And if you're using a different GPON module, the way is different, okay? So that's it, a quick overview of how you manage the GPON module. And now let's go to the Zimaboard. I'm going to add a new connection and it could be one or and the protocol will be PPPoE. For the device, it will be Ethernet 0.35 create interface. And I will need to fill in my username and password. Alright, make sure it is assigned to the WAN firewall zone. Hit save and apply. Alright, so right after we hit save and apply, we have a successful IPv4 and IPv6, and now we are having a working internet connection. Alright, so let's verify that. Ping 1.1.1 and perfect. So to be sure, we are going to clear this one out and we're going to run bmount and then peth and then ethernet 0. Okay, and let's have a quick speed test. Alright, so you can see that we are running at 400 Mbps. And right here, I can see that the RX is around 64 megabyte per second. This is quite a lot. So I'm using a 200 Mbps internet plan. And yeah, the speed test usually will be double for download. And then if I refresh the page, I will see the traffic. Okay. Beside the web page and the Telnet management, you can also manage the Hisense module via edit age, or you can also go to the backup and restore. And then right here, you can do a full backup of the setting. For example, you can click on the backup one and it will provide you a config.xml file. You can open that and change the setting that you want to change. For example, you can change whatever the IP address for the module, as well as the username and the password, as well as you can change, let me see, LOID, LOID passwords, and a lot of things. After that, you can save it at a config.xml file. And after that, upload this one, so that the configuration could be restored. Okay, so three main ways to config the GPON module: via the web page, via the config file, or via edit age or telnet. Alright, so just now we already have an overview of the internet service provider provided device and how do we replace that. So I hope this video will be useful for you, and if you have any idea or question, feel free to leave it in the comment section. Thanks for watching, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye bye.